I would like to acknowledge and pay my respects to the traditional owners, the Wurundjeri people of the Kulin Nation, on whose country we meet today. I would also like to extend my respects to their elders, past, present, and emerging. Hello and welcome to the 2020 Premier Sustainability Awards, held for the first ever time online. I'm Jane Bunn and I'm privileged to be with you today from the beautiful Botanical Gardens in Melbourne to celebrate truly inspirational Victorians who are leading the way in sustainability. Today, we are here to celebrate the 18th year of the awards through the magnificent efforts of our finalists. We'll hear the stories of communities, individuals, businesses, government, volunteers, and schools whose outstanding innovations and creativity are leading the way in Victorian sustainability. This year saw the largest number of entries in the awards history, and as you'll soon discover, Victorians are developing world-class sustainability initiatives in more efficient and clever ways than we've ever seen before. So congratulations to all 28 finalists. Each of them has made an outstanding contribution as Victorian leaders in sustainability. I'd like to thank the 33 independent awards judges who generously donated their time and nation partners who managed the entries and judging this year. I'd also like to thank the wonderful sponsors, Environment Protection Authority Victoria, sponsor of the Environmental Protection category, and the Department of Environment, Land, Water and Planning, a sponsor of the Environmental Volunteering category. This year, we are recognising finalists and announcing winners across 10 categories. These categories are built environment, community, education, environmental protection, environmental volunteering, government, health, innovative products and services, large business, and small and medium enterprises. Following the presentation of the 10 category awards, we then have two special award winners, personally chosen by the Premier. The Premier's Regional Recognition Award and the Premier's Recognition Award. Each of today's winners will receive a beautiful trophy, specially made for the awards from handcrafted reclaimed timber. And if you'd like to share the celebrations with the world today, please use hashtag PSAwards20. Before we begin to announce the winners, I would like to introduce the Premier of Victoria, Daniel Andrews.
This year we've been reminded of the things that matter most, our connection to each other and to the place we call home. These awards honour that connection and the individuals and organisations working to protect it for future generations. I'd like to congratulate all of those who have been selected as finalists and winners. And on behalf of every community and every corner of our state, thank you. Your efforts are helping to achieve a better, stronger, and more sustainable tomorrow.
Thank you, Premier Andrews. Let's now hear from the Honourable Lily D'Ambrosio, Minister for Energy, Environment and Climate Change, and Minister for Solar Homes, to welcome you to the awards.
Good afternoon and welcome to the 2020 Premier Sustainability Awards. I'm pleased to be with you virtually today for the announcement of this year's winners. I would like to begin by acknowledging the land where I am today, the land of the Wurundjeri peoples of the Kulin Nation. I pay my respects to elders, both past and present, and the elders from other communities who may be here with us today. I would also like to acknowledge Sustainability Victoria, who deliver these prestigious awards on behalf of the Victorian Government. Thank you for your hard work and dedication in bringing these awards to life. It's a very special event where we recognise and reward Victorians making a positive impact on our environment, promoting leadership and innovation in sustainability, and encouraging others to adopt similar practices. The Premier Sustainability Awards showcase Victorian communities and businesses who are leading the way through sustainable innovation. They demonstrate how the efficient use of resources such as water, materials and energy, as well as waste reduction and working together is fundamental to our future. As Minister for Energy, Environment and Climate Change and Minister for Solar Homes, I'm continually inspired by individuals, households, schools, communities and businesses who are embracing sustainable practices to help create the state of the future. The actions we take now will ensure Victoria has a cleaner, greener future. This includes Recycling Victoria, our new $300 million plan to overhaul Victoria's recycling sector. This is a once-in-a-generation transformational change, one that involves all Victorians. including households, local government, business and industry, and community organisations. We'll create almost 4,000 jobs and reduce waste going to landfill. Delivering a circular economy for Victoria requires the right infrastructure. We're investing $77.5 million in waste and recycling industry and infrastructure development, and the outcomes of the first round of funding will be announced latest this year. Victoria's doors are open to business. We want to hear your proposals for the infrastructure we need to deliver a recycling sector Victorians can rely on. Local councils play a key role in giving Victorians a waste and recycling system they can rely on. Recycling Victoria supports them through our $129 million household recycling reforms package. We've been working closely with all 79 Victorian councils to develop a statewide plan to transition to the new standardised 4-bin household waste and recycling system. Access to new recycling collections for glass and organics will maximise the value of curbside recycling and restore confidence. Better recycling habits means we will be able to use more of the materials collected from households to make new products. We will also implement a container deposit scheme by 2022-23 to encourage Victorians to recycle bottles, cans and other drink containers outside of the home. Public consultation on the proposed scheme is underway, and I encourage you all to make a submission. Meanwhile, our investment in renewable energy will create thousands of jobs and stimulate the economy, all while delivering clean and affordable electricity for Victorians to help meet net zero emissions target by 2050. Thanks to our landmark solar homes program, more than 79,000 Victorians have already installed rebated solar panels, batteries and solar hot water systems. None of us can go at it alone. Our state sustainability achievements belong to those Victorian individuals, organisations and businesses who are leading by example. Now, in its 18th year, the Premier's Sustainability Awards recognise Victorians who are spurring innovative change within their communities, reducing emissions, increasing resilience to the impacts of climate change and creating more livable cities. I'd like to acknowledge and congratulate this year's finalists and winners across the award categories. Together, you're helping to shape a cleaner, greener Victoria. I'm proud of the journey Victorians are taking to make our state more sustainable, many of whom are represented amongst this year's finalists. Your work to create and maintain a strong, healthy environment cannot be underestimated. Let's celebrate this year's wonderful finalists and winners of the 2020 Premier's Sustainability Awards. Thank you.
Thank you, Minister D'Ambrosio. I'd now like to introduce Sustainability Victoria's Interim Chair, Vicky Darling.
Good afternoon, everyone. As we wait in eager anticipation to hear the winners of this year's Premier Sustainability Awards, I would like to take this opportunity to share some highlights of the year. Sustainability Victoria empowers Victorians to reduce, reuse and recycle, to take action on climate change. I echo the sentiments of the Honourable Lily D'Ambrosio, as I too am inspired by the awards entries year on year. Now is the time to be bold, to find new solutions to old problems, to lead the change in your chosen fields. Sustainability Victoria is leading the delivery of 14 Recycling Victoria programs and supporting all Victorians to achieve the target of zero net greenhouse gas emissions by 2050. As we celebrate your successes today, we'd also like to share some of our highlights. Investment in research and timely access to market data is a core commitment of Sustainability Victoria. This year, we invested $1.6 million and leveraged a further investment of $8 million. By upgrading road specifications with the Australian Road Research Board, Victoria recycled 120,000 tonnes per annum of glass into road surfacing, more than any other jurisdiction in Australia. Victoria is the home for national investment in new recycling infrastructure, supporting leading-edge facilities such as Australia's most advanced plastic recycling facility at Advanced Circular Polymers. Through direct engagement, $100 million in private sector and local government funding has been leveraged, adding 600,000 tonnes per annum of recycling capacity. With leading expertise in behavioural insights, Sustainability Victoria has delivered successful behaviour change programs such as the Better Bag Habits campaign, which reached 9 million people, increasing awareness of the plastic bag ban among Victorians by 47%. A campaign to increase awareness of the e-waste to landfill ban reached 5 million Victorians. Know Your Recycling, which was designed to reduce contamination in household bins, was translated into six languages across TV and radio, with 700,000 Victorians accessing social media and website information. Even in the first month, a 2% reduction in recycling contamination for soft plastics and bag plastics was achieved. And, of course, our Resource Smart Schools program, which engaged 1,400 Victorian schools and 100 early learning centres, saving $2.8 million through energy, waste, water and biodiversity initiatives. Looking ahead, Sustainability Victoria has an ambitious agenda to deliver measurable impact at scale. To deliver a decade of action, we will embrace bold opportunities, working in partnership with all levels of government, industry and communities, with you, as together we transition to a low-carbon future. Thank you and good luck.
Thank you, Vicky. Let's now hear a special message from Sustainability Victoria's Chief Executive Officer, Claire Ferris-Miles.
Hello. Now in its 18th year, the Premier Sustainability Awards engage and inspire leadership and innovation across a range of sectors. Your contributions, your effort, time, and dedication to your community, your industry, your sector, and to the Victorian economy is noticed and recognised. This year, despite 2020 being the most unusual of years, we received a record number of entries, a 36% increase from 2019. The calibre and quality of the 28 finalists across 10 categories are a showcase of Victorian creativity and impact. I would like to thank the awards judging panel that included a range of environmental and industry experts, and our category sponsors, the Department of Environment, Land, Water and Planning, and the Environment Protection Authority, Victoria. I hope you will build lasting connections through the Premier Sustainability Awards, connecting people with ideas and forming new partnerships that will accelerate solutions that reduce emissions and waste. On behalf of Sustainability Victoria, I look ahead with optimism and enthusiasm to deliver a decade of action, supporting all Victorians to transition to a climate-resilient circular economy. Good luck.
Now let's get on with the business of announcing the winners. The first category in the Premier Sustainability Awards is the Built Environment Award. This award is presented for excellence and innovation in sustainable building or sustainable construction projects. The finalists for the Built Environment Award are Fraser's Property Australia, Burwood Brickworks Shopping Centre. This shopping centre boasts a 6-star Green Star design rating, 100% renewable energy, 100% repurposed rainwater, and saw 99% of construction waste diverted from landfill. Fraser's are on target for Burwood Brickworks to be named the first Living Building Challenge accredited shopping centre. Mervac Group, house with no bills. This home has sustainable features to reduce energy bills through solar PV and battery system, glazing upgrades, insulation, lighting, zoned air conditioning, and heat pump hot water, achieving energy savings of 92%. Swinburne University of Technology and Wyndham City Council recycled waste plastics and glass fines in concrete footpath. This collaboration produced over 300 metres of footpath in Hoppers Crossing, which comprised over 2 tonnes of recycled waste plastics and 5 tonnes of glass fines, equivalent to nearly 200,000 plastics and glass bottles, an estimated 1,700 kilograms in carbon savings. Welcome back to the Minister to announce the winner of the first award. Minister, the winner of the Built Environment Award is...
Fraser's Property Australia, Burwood Brickworks Shopping Centre.
I'm Stephen Choi. I'm the Living Building Challenge Manager at Fraser's Property Australia. The Living Building Challenge is the world's most rigorous performance framework for buildings, and it's based on performance, so actual compliance and data rather than theoretical.
My name's Emily Watkinson. I'm a Development Manager at Fraser's Property. One of the reasons that I decided to work at Fraser's was specifically to work on this project. I mean, I try to be as sustainable as I can in my personal life, so it's really important for me to work on projects that are aligned in that way.
The Brickworks Shopping Centre was an attempt to build a project that was accessible to everyone. We wanted to prove it was possible to build an everyday building for ordinary people with the same criteria as any other shopping centre, as well as what we ended up doing here, which is build a building that's ultra environmentally progressive.
The rooftop urban farm, I think, is most people's favourite element. It's just so unique in a setting like this to have a space that connects people back to nature. And I just love seeing people come out here and they're just like, oh my God, look at this, it's amazing. And yeah, that's really special.
Every part of the building has been really carefully considered for its impact. So materials, many were salvaged, water we actually clean, energy we generate on the roof, waste we collect more than 13 separate waste streams. Indigenous culture has actually been brought right into the whole fabric of the space. In the construction process, we diverted more than 99% of waste that would have otherwise gone to landfill. There's more than 5,000 square meters of food growing on the farm and around the facade combined. It's a transformative experience to be involved in a project like this because you go from being one person to being another 5 years later, realizing that you're actually pushing the boundaries, doing something that hasn't been done before.
We should be doing everything with sustainability in mind and thinking about how we can lessen our impacts on the planet and making sure that what we've enjoyed is here for the future generations.
Thank you so much. We are extremely grateful to be acknowledged for the work we've done here. I'm just one person, but the project's made up of many, many individuals who work for many organisations. The lead consultant, NH Architecture, and the whole consultant team, the lead contractor, Hacer Group, then all of my colleagues at Frasers for being brave enough to undertake this project.
What's one of the major sustainability wins you've achieved on the project?
The main sustainability win that we achieved on this project is that this is the only building in Victoria at the moment that's regenerative, which means it's not just sustainable, actually gives back more than it takes.
Do you think that the Brickworks rooftop urban farm concept could be included in future large-scale buildings?
The urban farm concept we have here on the roof at Bird Brickworks should be something that's used in multiple projects. In fact, if you have a roof, it shouldn't just be shelter. It should be collecting water, generating energy, and making food for people locally.
Congratulations, Frasers Property Australia. The second award category is the Community Award. This award is presented for leadership and excellence in the delivery of sustainable initiatives which have demonstrated widespread benefits for the Victorian communities. The finalists for the Community Award are Port Phillip Eco Centre and Werribee River Association, Living Water Workbees. This Port Phillip Bay collaborative community action saw a total of 132 workbees and over 2,600 volunteers. The workbees achieved the removal of over 4 tonnes of litter, planted over 3,000 plants, and conducted 14 citizen science biodiversity surveys. Queenscliff Music Festival, QMF's War on Waste. This true community effort in educating festival attendees and locals as well in sustainable waste practices saw 95% of waste diverted from landfill, 500 kilograms of excess food delivered to citizens in need, and engaged over 500 families in festival activities. Totally renewable Yakandanda, Yakandanda Virtual Power Plant. With a goal to run on 100% renewable energy by 2022, publicly owned buildings generate, store and share electricity to build a localised, low carbon and resilient electricity supply. The project saw the installation of solar generating an extra 100 megawatt hours of clean energy, significantly reducing carbon emission. Minister, the winner is...
Totally renewable Yakandanda. Yakandanda Virtual Power Plant.
My name is Matt Charles Jones. I'm a chairperson of Totally Renewable Yakandanda. The virtual power plant is the installation of a wide range of solar generation on 10 public buildings, starting with the Yakandanda Fire Brigade. And we eventually finished off with solar panels and a battery on the sports stadium. And we've added the batteries to reduce consumption from the grid overnight so that when the electricity supply network goes down, we've actually got a resilient supply of electricity on key public buildings.
My name's Juliet Milbank and I'm the communications coordinator for Totally Renewable Yakandanda. I think the community as a whole is moving towards being much more sustainable and is really setting an example for other communities that this is entirely doable and it has benefits at all sorts of levels. And it's such an important town, I think, to show what can be done. That's an incredibly exciting thing to be a part of.
I'm Kim McConaughey. I'm the Secretary for Totally Renewable Yakandanda. When you're being confronted with a few challenges that you're all working to overcome and you're working together for it, it's a great degree of satisfaction to have signed it off and got to the stage where you can look at it and go, yep, we ticked that box, we got that job done. We can now, with confidence, go on to even bigger projects, which is what we're doing.
So the broad goal that we have in Yakandanda is to generate 100% of our electricity needs by the year 2022 from renewable energy. The virtual power plant has added an additional 74 kilowatts of solar generation to Yakandanda. In total, we're estimating that we're going to generate an additional 104 megawatt hours per year from the solar installs we've added. One of our goals was really to place renewables in the heart of community volunteer groups. So it's really normalising renewable energy in our community. Oh, we just can't believe we've been honoured in this way. What an amazing acknowledgement of the hard work of a community. So obviously we're really very thankful to the Victorian government for enabling. But the community-owned petrol station, the Yakandanda Folk Festival, a whole bunch of community volunteer committees on the public buildings, and the Into Our Hands Foundation have made this possible. And we reckon we've got a great result with the project. We've got a whole range of public buildings cooperating on energy to achieve a terrific shared outcome. We're just overwhelmed by this acknowledgement. Thank you.
With a number of buildings and organisations in Yakandanda, have you found that your community groups have learned from each other through this project?
Yeah, well, there's now such a lot of renewables in Yakandanda at the moment. There's a real cross-pollination going on with inspiration and ideas about how to get great outcomes, both with renewable energy, but also reinventing the economy of our town.
What piece of advice would you give to other Victorian communities who are looking to embark on a similar renewable energy journey?
So the results we're getting in Yakandanda in all sorts of ways with renewable energy and efficiencies are just stunning. So my advice to other communities is don't wait around for perfect solutions. Get on with what can be done now and the results will be immediate. The opportunities are huge.
Well done, Yakandanda. Well on your way to your 2022 goal. Good luck. The next category is the Education Award. This award is presented for excellence in delivery and innovation in educational programs that contribute to a more sustainable Victoria. The finalists for the Education Award are Deakin University Blue Carbon Lab, Blue Carbon Army, Education by Immersive Wetland Citizen Science. Swapping suits for gumboots, this program connects Australia's corporate executives to nature and educates them in climate change, building scientific trust to support nature-based climate solutions that lead to a sustainable future. Monash Climate Change Communication Research Hub, Changing Climates, Victoria's first dedicated local climate column. This weekly column, which focuses on sustainability initiatives of local residents and businesses, incorporates Bureau of Meteorology data and simple graphs from suburban weather stations. It was published in local press and reached 1.5 million readers. Mount Waverley Primary School, MWPS Sustainability Hub. This outdoor and nature-based learning hub educates students and staff about sustainability and to be environmentally aware, responsible citizens. The hub focuses on gardening, cooking, and waste reduction and has a five-stream recycling system, water tanks, and Indigenous gardens. Minister, who will be the Education Award winner today?
Deakin University Blue Carbon Lab. Blue Carbon Army, Education by Immersive Wetland Citizen Science.
My name is Peter McCready. I'm an associate professor of marine science, and I also head up the Blue Carbon Lab at Deakin University. We're at war with climate change, and I think a lot of people feel helpless. So the Blue Carbon Army was formed to allow people to get involved in research that's looking at one of the most powerful ecosystems on the planet, the carbon drawdown. The program was about improving climate literacy. It was introducing concepts about natural capital, which is around how the ecosystems help to support our economy and also support our human well-being as well.
So my name is Maria Palacios, and I am the lead scientist and project manager of the Blue Carbon Army. We've had more than 300 people come through. They come from HSBC, Qantas, Geelong Port, ANZ, Woodside Energy. We teach them a bit about sustainability and climate change and coastal wetlands. And then we put on their gumboots and take them into the field. So when we go into the field, they're helping us collect data that helps us understand how much carbon are the wetlands capturing and how much carbon of that is helping us offset climate change emissions.
This program involved 21 different companies. There were more than 300 participants. We've seen an 80% increase in their knowledge about climate change, concepts around natural capital and ecosystem services, what the planet does for us. That's one of the reasons why banks like HSBC are investing $100 billion in sustainable finance. We're empowering people with knowledge. I think that sets them up for the future. It's giving them practical things that they can be doing in their everyday lives. And what more could you ask for to impart that sort of knowledge on others? Woohoo! This is very exciting. A huge thank you to HSBC Bank, in particular Alpa Bhattacharjee, who let us throw her co-workers, hundreds of them, out in the mud with us. We thank you so much for their financial support to make this happen. We thank our partners at Earthwatch. Earthwatch made sure everything ran smoothly and nobody got hurt. We also thank Deakin University for their great financial co-investment.
Last but not least, we also want to thank the 300 participants that joined the Blue Carbon Army and got muddy in the field with us to help advance citizen science research.
Let's take a little break and share a story with you about a very special little boy called Felix, who is officially our youngest entrant into the awards this year. Felix's passion for picking up waste at his local beach to protect our waterways and oceans is something that not only earned him a commendation from the judges for his entry this year, but is an inspiration on what one young person can achieve.
My name is Felix. I'm 8 years old and I go to Mandarin Grammar School. My website is called Little Protectors and it tells children to join my team and save the environment by picking up rubbish. I saw rubbish on the beach and I was just feeling sorry for all of the whales, turtles and fish out there. The rubbish pollution is killing the wildlife, so I decided to do what I can for them. I collect rubbish on Mordialla to Mentone Beach. I do it once a week after school. I've collected about 75 shopping bags since 2018 and 45 shopping bags since 2019. It makes me feel proud, especially when people say thank you to me. My hope for the future environment is that everyone will pick up their rubbish and bin them in a local bin so no one will have to clean up after them. It's important not to litter because we share the earth with other creatures, so if we protect them, we have to respect them.
Thank you, Felix. Just goes to show that leadership in sustainability can start at any age. Keep up the great work. Let's keep going with the announcements. The next category is environmental protection. This award is for leadership and excellence by an organisation in protection and prevention of harm to the environment. Before we announce the winner, I'd like to welcome the Environment Protection Authority Victoria category sponsor, that's Professor Kate Orty, Governing Board Chair, to say a few words.
A very warm hello to all of you who are here today for the Premier's Sustainability Awards 2020. I acknowledge the Tungurung people on whose lands I live and work, and I acknowledge their elders past, present and emerging. I also acknowledge them for their contemporary aspirations and their deep and abiding cultural connection. It's my pleasure on behalf of the EPA to also acknowledge the Honourable the Premier, Daniel Andrews, the Honourable Minister, Lily D'Ambrosio, the Secretary of the Department, John Bradley, the Acting Chair of Sustainability Victoria, Vicky Darling, and Claire Ferris-Miles, who is the CEO of Sustainability Victoria. The EPA has now been sponsoring this particular award, the Environment Protection Award, since 2013. And we do this because we recognise how critically important it is for us all to acknowledge and celebrate the work that people do to protect the environment as individuals and through their organisations. It's the case that this has been a hard year. It's been difficult, but nevertheless, people have stepped up, they've shown thought leadership, they've collaborated, and they've done inspiring work, which is recognised in these awards and these finalists today. 2021 will also be a year that challenges us. At EPA, we're looking forward to the new legislation, the Environment Protection Amendment Act, and being able to bring the general environmental duty to the community and engage the community with what we need to do to further advance our efforts.
Thank you, Kate. The finalists for the Environmental Protection Award are Port Phillip Eco Centre and Yarra River Keeper Association, Clean Bay Blueprint Microplastics Trawls. This research project implemented a range of initiatives, including quantifying how much plastic pollution reaches the bay from Metro Melbourne and identifying problematic items, then tracing it back to the pollution source so reduction plans can be designed and implemented. Queenscliff Music Festival, QMF's War on Waste. This festival saw 95% of waste generated from the event diverted from landfill. With 24,000 attendees over 3 days, only 178 kilograms of waste was sent to landfill, a staggering 82% decrease. The event is the first of its size to become fully reusable, with all vendors serving reusable crockery, cups and cutlery, ensuring less waste and cleaner grounds. Yarra Riverkeeper Association and Clean Water Group, litter and polystyrene pollution in the Yarra. Recognising the diabolical effects of litter and polystyrene pollution to the health of the Yarra, this collaboration held 4 large-scale community clean-up events, removing almost 18,000 kilograms of vacuumed waste and 700 kilograms of community collected waste. The winner of the Environmental Protection Award is
Yarra Riverkeeper Association and Clean Water Group, litter and polystyrene pollution in the Yarra.
My name is Andrew Kelly, and it's my privilege to be the Yarra Riverkeeper.
My name is Corinne Traeger, and I'm the CEO from the Yarra Riverkeeper.
We are a river city. We settled here because of the river, and we're still here because of the river. I feel very sentimental about this river because I grew up not too far from its banks. The litter and polystyrene project in the Yarra was about figuring out what was in the river. We were really fortunate that we had this partnership with the Clean Water Group. They're a great group. They really think things through, and it really helped us think things through. And what we worked out was that 50% of the rubbish in the river is polystyrene. That was actually coming from building sites, industrial sites, shopping centres. So that was a big step forward for us.
As we know, polystyrene lasts for 500 years and pollutes waterways, affects wildlife and flora. So that's why it's so important to track it, to try to push better policy for that.
The activities that we undertook was sampling the litter traps. So we would sample them over a period of, I think it was a year, 18 months. We vacuumed the reed beds, and then we had the public Yarra River blitzes. We got people out in kayaks to pick up rubbish on the river, and they were fantastic fun. Some of the things that we're really proud of is that we vacuumed up 17,500 kilos of vacuumed waste. And I'm also really proud that the community collected 665 kilos of waste.
I think right now the world's changing. we need to start getting better in terms of how we become more sustainable as human beings, you know, businesses, corporations, and that's why we have to find a response for climate change and what's happening. If we don't act right now, in the next 20, 30 years, it's going to be too late.
I am so excited. There are so many people who contributed to this project who deserve credit. I'd like to thank the community first up who came down and picked up the litter on the river in our blitzes. I'd like to thank Melbourne Water for sponsoring those blitzes. I'd particularly like to thank Dr. Nicole Kowalczyk, who was there at the beginning of this project as our litter and education officer, who then ran the project all the way to its final blitz in February. I'd like to thank Clean Water Group for being such terrific partners, such thoughtful partners. That's Aaron, Doug, and Cheyenne. I'd like to thank the skilled volunteers who came along and counted endless bits of litter. And I'd finally like to thank our fantastic staff at the Riverkeeper Association. Without them, this just wouldn't happen.
Next up is the Environmental Volunteering Award. This award is for leadership in volunteering, either by groups or individuals, in protecting and improving the environment for social, economic, and environmental outcomes. Before we announce the winner, I'd like to welcome the Environmental Volunteering category sponsor, John Bradley, Secretary of the Department of Environment, Land, Water and Planning, to say a few words.
Well, let me begin by acknowledging the traditional owners of the land from which we're all participating in today's event. I'm coming to you from the lands of the Wurundjeri people of the Kulin Nations, and I pay my respects to their elders past, present and emerging. And I recognise the work that we do in my department and environmental volunteers do right across Victoria on the country of First Nations peoples. Well, it's a great delight to be here to celebrate the Environmental Volunteering Award again. DELP's been proud to sponsor this award again this year, and we've been supporting it since 2019 when it first commenced. This award celebrates the groups and individuals that put themselves forward to serve as environmental volunteers to the benefit of the Victorian environment and our whole community. And there are certainly an incredible range of environmental volunteers right across Victoria. There's around 186,000 of these incredible individuals giving back to the community through environmental volunteering. And even in the tough year we've had in 2020 with the COVID challenge, this amazing group of people have given around $100 million worth of benefit to the community and almost 2.45 million hours of their time in serving the community as environmental volunteers. For DELP, environmental volunteering is a really core part of our mission under Biodiversity 2037. Under that plan, we're seeking by 2037 to not only make sure that every Victorian feels connected to nature, but also we target up to 5 million Victorians working actively to protect the natural environment. And that's a big, bold, ambitious target that relies on people who are environmental volunteers putting up their hands, rolling up their sleeves, and doing the amazing work that we're seeing being done. DELP's trying to support our environmental volunteers across the state, working alongside the community to deliver programs such as Land Care, Coast Care, Land for Wildlife, Water Watch and Estuary Watch, as well as many other citizen science projects. And we're so thankful for the incredible efforts of this amazing group of individuals. Let me finish by saying congratulations to everyone that was nominated as part of today's awards. It is an amazing gift that you give to the state of Victoria. I hope you enjoy today's virtual celebrations and we look forward to celebrating the winners today. Thank you.
Thank you, John. The finalists for the Environmental Volunteering Award are Sea Shepherd Victoria, Sea Shepherd Marine Debris Campaign Victoria. This campaign hosted 34 community cleanups with the support of 2,000 volunteers, removing 4,000 kilograms of litter from the marine environment. The cleanups recorded litter data for research, supported community conservation groups, and raised awareness of plastic's impact on our environment. Volunteers of Bellarine Catchment Network and volunteers of the Queenscliff Music Festival, QMF's War on Waste. The Bellarine Catchment Network collaborated with the festival volunteers to provide expertise in developing sustainability initiatives that saw an 86% increase in the total number of community volunteers. The festival went fully reusable, resulting in only 178 kilograms of waste sent to landfill. Volunteers of Greta Valley Landcare Group paddock trees, the lonely battlers of our landscape. These volunteers planted over 1,500 native shrubs and 300 new paddock trees and protected 46 remnant trees in the catchment. The project delivered lasting agricultural productivity, with the new trees providing shade and shelter for stock and increasing local biodiversity. The winner of the Environmental Volunteering Award is...
Volunteers of Bellarine Catchment Network and Volunteers of the Queenscliff Music Festival. QMF's War on Waste.
My name is Andrew Orvis. I'm the Festival Director with the Queenscliff Music Festival.
So we're a community-based, not-for-profit festival run annually by over 500 people and a small dedicated staff. We occupy the parkland in Queenscliff right next to the beach. So it's a beautiful location in a beautiful old historic seaside town. The War on Waste project that we initiated was looking at essentially reducing our footprint waste-wise down to zero. So the Bellarine Catchment Network were engaged as community volunteers to assist with our waste management. We had 100 plus volunteers that were managing our waste, manning our commercial dishwasher station. They were collecting rubbish from the ground that might have not made its way to the bins. So that was 100 plus bin fairies, dishwashers, waste picker-uppers that were involved. Part of our partnership with Bellarine Catchment Network was the educational component for our festival attendees. So there was lots of imagery created that was going on our bins and bin hubs, trying to assist them in sorting their waste. There was propagation programs, so families were able to propagate plant that was then planted locally in an effort to reduce our carbon footprint. So our War on Waste achieved a 95% reduction in waste to landfill on the previous year. We saw an 86% increase in community volunteers that were engaging with our War on Waste program. Overall, over 3 days and 25,000 plus festival attendees, we managed to only send 178 kilos of waste to landfill. We managed to rescue 500 kilos of food thanks to partnerships with our 22 food vendors that are at the festival, and that food was sent to Feed Me Bellarine, which is a local community organisation that sends food to people who need it more. It was absolutely a joint effort between Bellarine Catchment Network and QMF volunteers. Without their help and support and, I guess, expertise, we wouldn't have been able to achieve what we did. Thank you very much. It's an honour to win this award. I'd like to thank our amazing volunteers, the 100 plus volunteers that helped us do this project and helped us achieve these fantastic results, particularly our two team leaders, Wayne and Brooke, who led these volunteers and worked so very hard over the festival weekend, to our board for the support and to our staff for their amazing work on the project. I'd like to thank the Bellarine Catchment Network for their hard work and dedication and also their guidance and education. I'd like to thank Be Alternative, who are our waste partner for the event. And I'd like to thank our patrons in particular, who this was a big significant change for a music festival event and something that's never happened before. And they bought in, they worked really hard, and they generally did the right thing and achieved such fantastic results. So a big thank you to them.
Now for the Government Award. This award is presented for leadership and excellence by all levels of government in delivering outstanding sustainability outcomes through policies or initiatives. The finalists for the Government Award are Bass Coast Shire Council, Bass Coast BioLinks. With the aim to improve the capacity for plants and animals to adapt to the predicted impacts of higher temperatures, the BioLinks program planted 380,000 indigenous plants to enhance vegetation along waterways and retain water in the landscape. City West Water, stormwater harvesting for a greener West. This program provides increased accessibility to stormwater for public open spaces and greening of the urban environment. It established guidelines for the introduction of new products to reduce customer water bills by $26,000 a year. Department of Health and Human Services Energy Smart Public Housing Research Project. This project assisted residents of 1,500 public housing dwellings across Victoria to effectively reduce their electricity bills and environmental footprint. Interventions were designed to reduce greenhouse gas emissions in a considered approach to the privacy and empowerment of the tenants. Minister, the winner is...
City West Water, stormwater harvesting for a greener West.
I'm Sean Hanrahan, I'm the Service Planning Manager at City West Water, and our area plans the future growth services for water, sewer and alternative water for the west of Melbourne. The Stormwater Harvesting Fund was established in 2018 to reduce drinking water consumption, support urban greening and to make a more livable community for Melbourne's west. The aim of the project is to partner with local government to deliver local stormwater harvesting projects where our customers and community need them most. So with this project, we partnered with the Moonee Valley Council to deliver the stormwater infrastructure you can see here, which includes a wetland and the ability to use the water that we've collected here for irrigation. So this drainage point collects the stormwater from the community upstream and drains it into this large wetland. And from here, the grasses and natural flora and fauna clean up the water so we can use it for other purposes. By capturing the stormwater in the local community that is often contaminated and treating it in these wetlands, we're able to reuse the water and also create a beautiful space for the community to enjoy. The Stormwater Harvesting Fund has reduced our customers' bills by $26,000, and we're capturing and treating stormwater that would otherwise end up in the bay and removing the pollutants, and so we're helping the health of the Port Phillip Bay and reducing flooding and erosion impacts by treating and capturing that water locally. It's vitally important that organisations like City West Water play a leading role in environmental initiatives. I'm really proud to work on these projects because they deliver community value. We're really committed to fighting climate change and providing green open spaces for our community, so these stormwater harvesting projects are delivering on all of that. And we see them as a really key part of our future, and I could be more excited to be part of it. Wow, we're so excited to have won this award. We couldn't be more thrilled to be recognised for our work on the Stormwater Harvesting Fund. We'd like to thank all the partners that have helped get us to this point. That includes the state government, Melbourne Water, local councils, and the planning, delivery, communications, and engagement teams at City West Water that have helped make this possible. Thanks again.
Let's take another small break from our announcements to share with you another story about two Melbourne girls who combined their love for attending events with their passion for wanting to make an environmental difference after seeing how much plastic waste goes to landfill from festivals and events across Australia.
My name is Christy Camphouse. I'm the co-founder of Better Cup, and I focus on the marketing and strategy of our company.
My name's Sam Stone, and I take care mostly of the operational side of things.
Better Cup is a female-founded local Melbourne business where we create locally made reusable bar cups and supply reusable systems to major events and venues across Australia. So that's things such as washing and drying systems on-site and off-site, reuse implementation consulting, storage and recycling for end of life. We were founded in 2015 and we started off really small, doing local events before we scaled up, and we've seen the largest amount of growth since 2018.
Chrissy and I met in 2008 on a dance floor and we've been friends ever since. We love events and we love sustainability, and we got to put them together in this way that would allow us to go to events and also help them reduce waste.
One of our biggest achievements was over the New Year period, where we worked with all four of the Falls festivals across Australia. That was a big coordination effort.
We saved 350,000 single-use cups, which is 3.5 tonnes of waste. There's so many other people that care in the same way that we do, and it feels like we're part of this groundswell movement in Victoria to just do our best, and everyone's doing their part, and it's really good.
What an inspirational story and a great example of the breadth of innovation that we see at the awards every year. Next up is the Health Award. This award recognises leadership and excellence in the delivery of initiatives that contribute to sustainable outcomes in the health sector and community. The finalists for the health category are Alfred Health, War on Waste. To avoid and reduce waste, improve segregation and reduce contamination, Alfred Health rolled out waste signage systems and a carefully considered bin layout. This strategy saw recycling rates improve by 50% and improved staff sustainability engagement. Bendigo Health, reducing waste to landfill via recycling curtains. Needing to be replaced every 12 months for quality purposes, Bendigo Health sought a recycler who would accept their bed curtains in baled form. The facility has successfully diverted a ton of curtains from landfill, whilst fostering a sense of patient and employee pride. Minister, the winner of the Health Award is...
Bendigo Health, reducing waste to landfill via recycling curtains.
My name's Cindy Bird. I work for Bendigo Health Facilities Management and I'm the waste officer here. We've been working with Replas to reduce our waste to landfill and especially the curtains. Bendigo Health has a 724-bed hospital. We service all of regional Victoria. Sustainability for the hospital is very important as we are one of the largest producers of waste in the Bendigo region. Our effect onto the landfill is massive and we try and reduce as much as we can. So with the introduction of our new hospital, which is coming up to 4 years, we implemented disposable curtains in the hospital. So they are replaced every 12 months if they're not soiled. They are made of a polypropylene material. There are impregnated anti-mildew chemicals in the curtains. So they are recyclable, but not through normal waste and recycling collection. So we had to work hard to find a recycler. And coming from a hospital environment as well, a lot of recyclers stay away from the hospital setting. So working with Replas, we found that if they didn't have to touch the curtains and they were baled, that they would be able to be recycled. And the polypropylene material is something that they certainly are keen to recycle. So with the baler, it takes about 80 of our curtains at one time and it compacts that very heavily into a bale. We believe they are about 200 kilos and that Replas needed a 200 kilo sample to start and they trialled it and it worked. Even the string that we use to bale the curtains is recyclable. They started to stockpile in the old hospital until we found a recycler. So we've been running now for 4 years and they're changed over every 12 months. So it soon adds up. We believe we've saved over a ton from landfill. We have diverted 10 tonnes of soft plastics in the time. We've implemented soft plastic recycling as well. I would love to see zero waste to landfill. Reducing our impacts on the environment is important to all of us and for all Australians, and Bendigo Health especially. Thanks everyone, this is great news for Bendigo Health and we're very excited to have won the Premier Sustainability Awards. We'd like to thank Replas for recycling our curtains, as well as Victorian Health and Human Services Building Authority for the Sustainability Innovation Grant that made this possible through the funding of the baler. Thanks to everyone at Bendigo Health for all your hard work and keep on recycling.
Congratulations, Bendigo Health. The next category is the Innovative Products or Services Award. This award is presented for outstanding innovation in products or services that contribute to sustainable outcomes. The finalists for the Innovative Products or Services category are Green Eco Technologies Wastemaster. The Wastemaster reduces food waste by up to 80% in 24 hours using low levels of energy. A reduction of 84% in greenhouse gas emissions is achieved when compared to disposing the same waste to landfill. Repurpose It, Australian first washing plant. Establishing a niche in construction waste materials, this plant recovers sands, aggregates from waste, and processes contaminated soil. The plant diverted 148,000 tonnes from landfill in its washing process and produced 141,000 tonnes of renewed materials. Shull's Organic Dairy, Shull's organic dairy milk in glass bottles. Set out to bottle their milk in reusable glass bottles, Schultz now delivers 3,000 glass bottles of organic milk weekly to over 50 retailers Victoria-wide. This initiative has averted 10,000 kilograms of plastic bottles from landfill. Minister, the winner of the Innovative Products or Services Award is...
Repurpose It, Australian first washing plant.
My name is George Hatzimanolis and Managing Director and Co-Founder of Repurpose It. Repurpose It was founded in March of 2017 by myself and four regional business partners. So Repurpose It, we've invested in Australia's first washing plant. It's the only of its kind in the country. We adopted it off European best practice in terms of recycling, and it was after extensive research into the type of technology available to recover really challenging waste streams. So if you think about building big infrastructure projects, road, rail infrastructure, they generate waste spoil. That waste has to go somewhere. In the past, when that waste has been contaminated, it ends up in landfill. We take that problematic waste and we put it through our washing process. Our washing process uses high pressure water, screening and a lot of attrition, and we scrub, clean and recover the valuable amount of resource left in there.
I'm Patrick Malanafi. I'm the washing operations manager here at Repurpose It. So the excavation waste comes here in tandem trucks. We tip it off at the excavator and then it scrubs, washes, and it has a water treatment plant. The water's fully recycled, so we don't use all the natural resource, all the fresh water. We recycle 99% of the water here on site. We can process up to 200 tonne an hour, and then we run 24 hours a day, 7 days a week.
In our first full year of operation, we've been able to divert over 148,000 tonnes of excavation waste from landfill. We've diverted over 24,000 tonnes of CO2 from the atmosphere. We've been able to produce 141,000 tonnes of sand, aggregate and clay that's then been sold out and given a second life.
So that's why I love coming in, seeing everything running, making sure and all the products coming off the belts is going to go for a beneficial engineering reuse, whereas you don't get that anywhere else in Australia, so that's why I'm so passionate about what I do.
I mean, for me, having a business with purpose that I believe in, that's important to me, that I can go home and tell my children about, and leaving them something behind is very important for me. But what's also important is that the people that we bring in to Repurpose It share the same values, and that makes this a really fun place to work.
On behalf of everyone here at Repurpose It, we are honoured and extremely proud to be receiving the 2020 Premier Sustainability Award. We are committed to preserving our resource for the next generation. Thank you.
Congratulations, Repurpose It! The next category is the Large Business Award. This award recognises large business leading in the implementation of sustainable outcomes. The finalists for the Large Business category are Alex Fraser, Laverton Sustainable Supply Hub. This recycling facility recovers diverse, high-volume priority waste streams and produces quality end products needed for infrastructure, meeting the demand for recycled products. The hub converted 200,000 tonnes of glass waste recycled into sand. Woolworths Group, Woolworths at Burwood Brickworks. Applying a holistic sustainability strategy across its Burwood Brickworks store operations, Woolworths adopted 44 sustainability initiatives. Results included 14% reduction in energy consumption, 68% food recovery, and over 30 kilograms of soft plastics recovered in 6 months of operations. Minister D'Ambrosio, the winner of the large business category, is
Alex Fraser, Laverton Sustainable Supply Hub.
My name's Peter Murphy. I'm the Managing Director here at Alex Fraser. So the Sustainable Supply Hub integrates three state-of-the-art facilities: the construction and demolition waste recycling plant, world's first glass recycling plant, and the high recycled technology asphalt plant. It provides the materials that people need to build greener roads on a massive scale. And the best part is, the really innovative parts are designed and built right here in Victoria. Every year, more than 1 million tonnes of material is brought here for recycling. We use a range of crushing, screening, air knife separation, magnetic separation, and a range of other technologies to separate the material to make high quality sand, asphalt, and road base for the construction industry.
My name's Natalie Montalto, and I'm a key account manager here at Alex Fraser. I help customers recycle their material back into their projects or back into the wider construction community. We help them work out what's best for them, which site they can go to, and what materials actually can be recycled, because more often than not, customers don't actually know that a certain array of materials can be recycled.
In the last year, we've delivered 2.5 million tonnes of material to build greener roads. And that includes more than 1 billion bottles worth of glass recycling and 500,000 tonnes of sustainable asphalt. And in 2020, we reached a really exciting milestone. We've recycled here more than 1 million tonnes of glass.
Super proud to be part of the team here at Alex Fraser, knowing that what we're doing is actually benefiting the planet and for future generations, as well as guiding me in my personal life to recycle more material and sharing that knowledge with other people. It's a fantastic feeling. It really is a fantastic feeling.
I'm really proud of what we all do here. We're preserving natural resources. We're keeping things out of landfill. Our customers are very focused on building projects on time, on spec, and on budget.
and we help them do that and get a better outcome for the environment.
This is fantastic. Thank you. It's great to get this recognition. I just want to say thanks to all the people that work at Alex Fraser every day to make it happen. And thanks to all our customers and the communities that we work with.
Well done, Alex Fraser. Before we announce the final award category, here is a story about an inspirational social enterprise entrant into the awards.
My name is Alice Ma, and I'm the co-founder of the Corner Store Network. The Corner Store Network is an organisation that's leading on environmental, economic and food justice. Primarily, we set it up as a coffee roastery, then cafe, and then we set up a preservation kitchen. We gather donations of produce from around the local area, and then we have about 50 volunteers that preserve it. My dad, my brother and my mum, Kathy Ma, is also involved. A family affair, yes.
My name's Andrew Ma. The journey with Alice has been a fascinating one, and one that I'm enormously proud of. She has a very strong passion for social justice, for fairness and for environmental justice.
So we have saved over 2 tonne of food from the local Monash area from going to waste or ending up in landfill. We've planted over 16,000 trees through sales of coffee, and we have saved over 21,000 disposable cups from ending up in landfill by not offering disposable cups as takeaway options. I grew up on the shoulders of my dad and in the arms of my mum at protests and rallies around Victoria, and they instilled in me that living your values is all you can do to lead a good life.
What fantastic innovation, Corner Store, and a great example of the kind of entries that we receive in the Premier's Sustainability Awards that address multiple social and environmental issues. So proud to be a Victorian seeing social enterprises like this. Here we go. The final category to announce is the Small and Medium Enterprises Award. This award is presented for outstanding achievements by small and medium enterprises in the implementation of sustainability outcomes. The finalists for the Small and Medium Enterprises category are Manrags Textile Recycling Initiative. To address the amount of textile waste generated by Australians each year, Manrags launched its sock recycling program. Since beginning, a community of 40,000 members have saved 13,000 kilograms of socks from going to landfill. Repurpose It, Australian First Washing Plant. In 2019, Repurpose It launched its washing plant to reuse construction waste that was historically sent to landfill. Since launching, the washing plant has saved over 148,000 tonnes of construction waste from landfill and enough carbon dioxide to offset 1,600 households. SJD Homes Z Range. With the average Melbourne home producing 7 tonnes of greenhouse gas and costing $4,000 in energy bills per year, SJD develops sustainable and affordable housing. The homes generate an average $650 in energy bills per year, dramatically reducing costs and greenhouse gases. Minister, who is our final category winner?
Repurpose It, Australian First Washing Plants.
The construction industry in particular generate large volumes of waste, and we really looked to see what was being done around the world to take in particular excavation waste and soil and repurpose it into high value engineering materials that we could sell back out to the construction market. So I'm a strong believer that our infrastructure of tomorrow won't be built with the same resource that we're using today. For me, this was a very natural fit in founding Repurpose It because the business and values that are very important to me in terms of taking waste and converting it to a resource and leaving some resource for the next generation. Well, on behalf of all the family here at Repurpose It, my original business partners and co-founders, Anthony Van Schaik, Mark and Elvis Centofanti, Abraham Pace, Michael and David Wilson, our business partners Downer, our key stakeholders being the Environmental Protection Agency of Victoria, Sustainability Victoria, thank you so much for this recognition. We're very proud, we're very honoured. This means the world to us, and we're excited about delivering a more sustainable outcome for our state moving forward.
How long was the journey from invention to innovation of the washing plants?
I'd like to say the idea was sparked 5 or 10 years ago, The research itself was undergone for about 2 years, and for the time that we decided to invest in the technology, it was a strong 18 to 24 months of build time, development approvals, and we've been operating now for a bit on 18 months.
Are you looking at other construction waste products for recycling in the future?
Absolutely. We're looking at different levels of contaminated waste. We think that there's plenty more opportunity in our washing technology to recover other types of resource. Contamination is a growing problem, in particular in soil, and we're really looking to what else we can do through our advanced washing and water treatment processes here at our washing plant in Epping.
That's it for our 10 category winners. What an incredible group of people leading our state on the sustainability front through passion, commitment, and innovation. But we are not yet done. Now to the two big awards. First up is the Premier's Regional Recognition Award. This award, chosen by the Premier of Victoria, Daniel Andrews, is awarded to one of the regional finalists of the award categories who have demonstrated notable sustainability benefits for regional Victoria. To announce the 2020 Premier's Regional Recognition Award, I'd like to ask Minister D'Ambrosio to do the honours. Minister, the winner of the Premier's Regional Recognition Award is...
Totally Renewable Yakandanga.
You know, we're wrapped. I'm thrilled that the Totally Renewable Yakandanga Committee has had this opportunity, and I'm thrilled that we've realised the idea of joining together individual public buildings into a virtual power plant. And actually, we're working really hard to make all of Yakandanga cooperate on electricity, and we're just overwhelmed with what this means for our community. So thank you to everybody involved.
What a fantastic achievement. It is terrific to see that sustainability is alive and well in regional Victoria. Now for the final award. The Premier's Recognition Award has also been chosen by the Premier of Victoria. This award is made to one of the category winners who showcase exemplary innovation in sustainability and has shown leadership and determination in overcoming obstacles. Minister, once again, could you please do us the honour? The winner of the Premier's Recognition Award is...
Yarra Riverkeeper Association and Clean Water Group.
I'm so excited. There are so many people who contributed to this project. Community, first up, who turned out and picked up the litter, who came to the River Blitzers. Dr. Nicole Kowalczyk, who was our Litter and Education Officer, who was amazing in delivering this project. Our partners, the Clean Water Group, Doug, Aaron and Cheyenne, they were fantastic, the best partners in the world. And last of all, our staff, who did a magnificent job in pulling the whole project together.
Congratulations to all winners and finalists. It has been inspiring. Thank you to everyone who entered the Premier Sustainability Awards in this challenging year. Your efforts in investing time and energy into sustaining Victoria's future is to be commended. Thanks again to our category sponsors, the Environment Protection Authority Victoria and the Department of Environment, Land, Water and Planning. And a final thanks to Sustainability Victoria for delivering these awards. This brings the official 2020 Victorian Premier Sustainability Awards to an end. I'm Jane Bunn. Thank you and goodbye.